So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. Mehu Manish Mishra and guys, in today's session, as usually, we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are important for the ESI section of RBI and NABARD. So let's begin with the session, guys. But before we begin, if you are new here, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon so that you can receive all the notifications regarding the videos. Let's begin with the very first question. Recently, the virtual Agri Hackathon Atmanirbhar Krishi was inaugurated by the Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, who is Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar. And he is also the Minister of Food Processing Industry and also the Minister of Rural Development and Panchayati Raj. So this hackathon was organized by Department of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare in association with DASH. So you have to fill this gap. कौन सी दो organization ने मिलके इस hackathon को organize किया है? One is already given in the question, that is the Department of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, and the another organization that you have to identify. So let's talk about the news first. The Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, as I told you, has inaugurated this virtual agri hackathon, which is named as Atmanirbhar Krishi, and it is, guys, a 2-month long event. Okay, and it is being organized by the Department of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare along with the Institute of Agricultural Research, IARI, which is located in Pusa. Okay, Institute of Agricultural Research located in Pusa. These two organizations, Department of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare and Institute of Agricultural Research, are together organizing this event. Alright, and talking more about this event, so this hackathon, guys, will accept the innovation and ideas in the field of farm mechanization, precision agriculture, supply chain and food technology, waste to wealth, green energy, solar energy, etc. Okay, aur isme kya hoga, total 24 winners honge. So 24 winners will be there, they will get INR 1000, but INR 1 lakh rupees cash prize unko milega, and incubation support will also be provided to them. All right, and it will happen in the 3 elimination rounds. So, and after the 3 elimination rounds, 24 winners will get a cash prize of rupees 1 lakh, and also the long term incubation support will also be provided by the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Okay, so therefore, guys, the correct answer should be what? So we have to identify the another organization. So one is the Department of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, another is IARI. Option B, Indian Institute of Agricultural Research, is the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number 2. For which two areas Trifed has signed an MOU with DAY NRLM, National Rural Livelihood Mission, to undertake economic support programs that will help boost livelihoods of the SHG women? SHG stands for self-help groups and tribal population. So SHG women ki livelihood ko enhance karne ke liye, there is an MOU that has been signed between Trifed and DAY NRLM, and of course DAY NRLM works under the Ministry of Rural Development. Okay, so we have to tell in which two areas, for which two areas this MOU has been signed. So let's talk about the news, guys. So as I told you, Trifed and DAY NRLM has signed an MOU. For what this MOU has been signed? What is the objective? That is to undertake economic support programs that will boost the livelihood of SHG women and also the tribal population in our country. And this MOU has been signed for two major areas. One is the minor forest produce, MFP, minor forest produce, and another is the handloom, or you can also say the handicraft areas. So these are the two areas for which this MOU has been signed. So let's talk more about this. For minor forest produce, guys, it has been agreed to establish synergy between the state rural livelihood mission, and the state implementing agencies that are implementing MSP for MFP. MSP is the minimum support price, while MFP is the minor forest produce. Okay, and the SRLMs, guys, will also participate in the implementation of the Vandhan Yojana. So Vandhan Yojana is a government scheme of the Ministry of Tribal Affairs. So this SRLM will also participate in the implementation of this scheme, that is Vandhan Yojana, and there will be development of common facility center like warehouses, primary processing of agricultural products, horticulture and minor food producers, etc. And talking about the other area, which is the handloom or the handicrafts area, so for this, Trifed will empanel the SHGs or FPOs. FPOs, guys, is Farmer Producer Organization, and Government of India is establishing 10,000 FPOs currently with majority tribal members and will enable the sale of their products through both online and offline mode. Okay, so these are the two areas for which this MOU has been signed. So therefore, I hope now you are able to answer the correct. So what was the question? For which two areas? Okay, so it is for handloom and minor forest produce, which means option E, 1 and 3 will be the correct answer. And now let's move on to next question. Question number 3. Recently, Prime Minister has laid the foundation stone of lighthouse projects under the green under the global housing technology challenge. Okay, this challenge, guys, is very important. That was launched in the year 2019. Global housing technology challenge ke under lighthouse project ki foundation stone rakha hai Prime Minister ne in 6 cities of the country. Question is, which of the following is not one of those 6 cities? And guys, this lighthouse project is very important. It is under the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban. And of course, we all know Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana is a government scheme, and government schemes are really important for our exam, ESI section, RBI grade B. And question number 4, guys, is also based on the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban. So the question is, Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs has launched a new certificate course on innovative construction technology. You just have to tell the name of the course. What is the name of the course? So this new course has also been launched by Prime Minister during this event. It is a certificate course on the innovative construction technologies. So let's talk about this news. So Prime Minister has laid the foundation stone for lighthouse projects under the global housing technology challenge in the 6 sites across 6 states in our country. And what is this lighthouse? Ye lighthouse hota kya hai? So guys, these are the houses which are built with the alternate technologies and which are very good for the environment, which does not cause any harm to the environment, and also which are suitable to the geoclimatic and hazardous condition of the region. And the maximum time limit which is being given to the agencies which are making this lighthouses is the 12 month. Unko 12 mahine ka time diya jayega maximum. Uske andar unko lighthouse ka jo bhi unko project hai wo complete karna hai. And these are the 6 sites where these lighthouse are being built. Number 1 is Indore, and these are the technologies, respective technologies which are which will be used in these lighthouse. Okay, so in Indore lighthouse project, prefabricated sandwich panel system is used. Now you don't have to go deep with this technology, that is not required for the exam. For Rajkot, it's monolithic concrete construction. Chennai, precast concrete construction system. Ranchi, again precast concrete construction system. Then Agartala, it's light gauge steel structural system. And finally, number 6, Lucknow, stay in place formwork system. And these are the number of lighthouses that will be built in these 6 cities, which are Indore, Rajkot, Chennai, Ranchi, Agartala and Lucknow. Okay, and talking about global housing technology challenge, so guys, it was launched by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs in the year 2019, and it has the objective to identify innovative global technology in the construction sector. कंस्ट्रक्शन सेक्टर में जो इनोवेटिव ग्लोबल टेक्नोलॉजी है उनको आइडेंटिफाई करना और उनको इंप्लीमेंट करना इन आवर कंट्री. एंड दिस हैज 3 कंपोनेंट्स. नंबर 1, ग्रैंड एक्सपो एंड कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑन अल्टरनेटिव एंड इनोवेटिव कंस्ट्रक्शन टेक्नोलॉजी. सो दिस एक्सपो गाइज वॉज ऑलरेडी हेल्ड इन द मंथ ऑफ मार्च 2019, ये हो चुका है इवेंट. नंबर 2 कॉम्पोनेंट इज आइडेंटिफाइंग प्रूवन डेमोन्स्ट्रेबल टेक्नोलॉजीज फॉर द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ लाइट हाउस प्रोजेक्ट, ताकि उन टेक्नोलॉजीज का इस्तेमाल किया जा सके वाइल बिल्डिंग द लाइट हाउस. ओके, एंड आइडेंटिफाइंग पोटेंशियल फ्यूचर टेक्नोलॉजीज फॉर इंक्यूबेशन एंड एक्सेलरेशन सपोर्ट अंडर द आशा इंडिया प्रोग्राम. ओके, एंड वॉट इज दिस आशा इंडिया? अफोर्डेबल सस्टेनेबल हाउसिंग एक्सेलरेटर्स. ओके, सो दिस इज अ प्रोग्राम अंडर ग्लोबल हाउसिंग टेक्नोलॉजी चैलेंज. एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस प्रोग्राम आशा इंडिया, सो अंडर दिस प्रोग्राम वॉट मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स इज डूइंग. So they are providing incubation and acceleration support to the new ideas, to the innovative ideas. And there are 2 components under it, which are pre-prototype and post-prototype. So pre-prototype, guys, are those technology which are at the ideation stage and which requires long-term incubation support. While if you talk about the post-prototype, so these are the technologies which are already in the market and which requires acceleration for marketing of their products. Okay, so there are 2 categories under Asha India program, and what I hope Asha India program is clear. It is just for providing the incubation and acceleration support to the technologies which are working in the construction areas. All right. And now these are the five institutions where ASHA India centers will be established, which are IIT Bombay, Madras, Kharagpur, Roorkee, and CSIR Northeast Institute of Science and Technology, which is located in Jorhat, Assam. Okay. So you have to remember these also, these five institutes where ASHA India centers will be established by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. All right. And now during the event, this news is about the question number 4. During the event, Prime Minister has also released a new certification course on the innovative construction technology, which is known as Navriti. Which is known as what? Navriti. And Navriti has a full form also. New Affordable Validated Research Innovation Technologies for India Housing. Okay. New Affordable Validated Research Innovation Technology for India Housing is the full form of Navriti. Okay. And this course, guys, is offered by the School of Planning and Architecture, which is located in Delhi, and also Building Materials and Technology Institute, which is also located in Delhi. The total duration of the course, guys, will be 7 days, and the fees is how much? Rupees 10,000 plus GST. Okay. So that is about this news. So now let's come back to question number 3 and 4. So we have to find which of the following is not one of those 6 cities. So Indore is there, Rajkot is there, Chennai, Ranchi is there. And other than this, Agartala and Lucknow are there. Agartala and Lucknow, which means Kanpur is not there. Therefore, option E, Kanpur, will be the correct answer. Okay. And question number 4. Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs has launched a new certificate course on innovative construction technology. You have to name the course. So I hope you can now answer it correctly. The correct answer should be what? Option B, Navriti. All right. So now let's move on to question number 5, which is the last question for today. So you have to consider the following statement regarding Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban Awards. So these awards have been given by the Prime Minister during that event only. And you have to identify the correct statement regarding these awards. So let's talk about the awards first. So Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Awards have been given. And guys, this is very important for our exam, because already Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban is already very important. And there is some new update in this scheme. So that is equally important. So among the best performing states category, number 1 it was Uttar Pradesh, number 2 Andhra Pradesh, and number 3 it is Andhra Pradesh. That is very, very important. Best performing state wala category is the most important category in these awards. Number 1 pe it's Uttar Pradesh, then we have Madhya Pradesh, and number 3 it is Andhra Pradesh. While the best performing state among the northeast and hilly states, it is Tripura. Okay, it is what? Tripura. While if you talk about the best performing municipal corporation, so it is Vishakhapatnam, which is of course in Andhra Pradesh, Chindwara, Madhya Pradesh, and Salem, which is in Tamil Nadu. Moving ahead to the best performing municipal corporation among the northeast and hilly states, so that is Agartala, which is located in Tripura, and it is of course the capital of Tripura. While talking about the best performing municipal council, so it is Kalin Bhaiya's Mirzapur, which is in of course Uttar Pradesh. Jhumri Talaiya, it is in Jharkhand. Dongargarh, Chhattisgarh, Mukom, Kerala, and Khurai, which is located in Madhya Pradesh. Now talking about the best performing Nagar Panchayat, so number 1 pe it is Malihabad, which is in UP. Then we have Athmalik in Odisha, Hariharpur, Uttar Pradesh, Thidavur, Tamil Nadu, and Shiohar, which is in Bihar. And these are some other categories, which is best performing Union Territory, it's Puducherry. Puducherry is the best performing UT in the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban Awards. Best innovative construction technology was Andhra Pradesh. Sabse zyada construction mein jo innovative technology state use karta hai, that is Andhra Pradesh. Best community mobilization initiatives, it is Jharkhand. And best policy initiatives, it is Gujarat. Gujarat mein sabse achhe policy initiatives hai related to the construction sector. Best project monitoring tools, it is once again Andhra Pradesh. So Andhra Pradesh is performing very well in these awards. Best affordable housing projects on public land, it's Madhya Pradesh, while on the private land, it's Gujarat. So these are some important categories, guys, that you have to remember in these awards. So now let's come back to the question number 5. Best performing state is Uttar Pradesh. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Number 1 pe it's Uttar Pradesh, number 2 Madhya Pradesh, and number 3 of course Andhra Pradesh. Best performing UT is Delhi. So is that Delhi? No, it is not Delhi, it's Puducherry, which means this statement is incorrect. And the award for best innovative construction technology was given to Andhra Pradesh. Yes, this is absolutely correct, which means we have two statements which are correct here. So therefore, option B, only 1 and 3 will be the correct answer. Okay, and guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.